Dear friends, English literature, romantic poetry, S.T. Coleridge, selected poems, The Rime of the Ancient Mariner, short questions and answers. Short questions 1 to 10. Question 1. What is an albatross? Why did ancient mariner kill the albatross? Answer. An albatross is a large seabird found mostly in the tropics, particularly the south of the Cape of Good Hope. The albatross looks much like a goose, but it is much bigger than a goose. The albatross, referred to in the rhyme of the Ancient Mariner, is a bird of good omen. It follows the ship of the Ancient Mariner for 9 days. The Ancient Mariner and his companions took the bird as an omen of good luck. But the bird made the winds blow. They gave it food and water, and it became very tame. But one day, the Ancient Mariner shoots the albatross without any apparent reason. Though he shoots the albatross, nowhere in the poem he explains his motives in shooting it. He might have killed it in a moment of annoyance, or anger, or mere frivolity, but we aren't sure. The uncertainty of the motives is quite important. It may show perversity of will or lack of understanding of the purpose behind the world's creations. It signifies the violation of the sanctified relations of the host and the guest. Question 2. How do the companions of the Ancient Mariner accomplish in the crime of killing the albatross? Answer. The albatross is a bird of good omen, but one day, the Ancient Mariner killed the albatross without any apparent reason. For this sinful act of Ancient Mariner, his companions had rebuked him. They said that it was a crime for him to kill the bird that made the wind blow. But a little later, when the sun rose in all its glory and the fog and mist cleared away, the companions of the Ancient Mariner changed their attitude and said that he had done right in killing the bird which was responsible for the fog and mist. Thus, with the change of the weather, there came of a change in the outlook of the sailors. The albatross brought fog and mist and was therefore a bird of bad omen. The Ancient Mariner had therefore done the right thing by killing it. This shows that the attitude of the sailors towards the crime was merely selfish and not based on moral principles. Question 3. How was the ship of the Ancient Mariner driven southward? Answer. The ship of the Ancient Mariner was driven southward by a violent storm. The storm blew from behind. By the force of the storm, the tall, erect masts of the ship were bent forward, and the front part of the ship seemed to be sunk under the water. Thus, the ship moved first before the storm. The ship here is compared to a man who runs as fast as he can, being chased by an enemy. The enemy is chasing from behind, shouting and striking the man. His shadow is cast before the man who is being chased. The man dare not look behind to see the enemy. He runs at top speed, bending his head forward. But however fast he runs, he cannot outdistance his enemy. So also the ship was driven fast by the roaring and striking storm from behind, but it could not get rid of the storm. Question 4. What is the condition of the South Sea? Answer. We know that the weather and atmosphere of the South Sea are always treacherous and unfriendly to human beings. Nobody could survive in this unfavorable environment. The ship of the Ancient Mariner was driven away by the stormy wind towards the South Sea. Ultimately, the ship reached a strange region of the sea which was devoid of the trace of life. They were surrounded by the icebergs floating on the sea. They were passing and repassing by the side of one another. While they were overtaking one another, there produced a cracking, growling, roaring, and a scratching sound. Sometimes the sound seemed to be that of a patient who has fallen in fit. Thus, the extreme loud sound has created an atmosphere of supernatural and mysterious world. Thus, an impression of utter dissolution is noticeable in the South Sea. Question 5. How does the ship of the ancient mariner enter the Pacific Ocean? Answer. The old sailor killed the albatross without any apparent reason, but after the killing of the albatross, the wind was favorable for the ship to enter the Pacific Ocean. At the time, as the ship cuts through the waves, it makes a track wave on the surface of water. The water was easily cut by the ship because there was no ice to block the passage, and the fair wind pushed at the sails. Then the ancient mariner and his companions suddenly entered the Pacific Ocean, which was silent and calm. Thus, the ship of the ancient mariner entered the Pacific Ocean very swiftly. The ancient mariner felt that their ship entered the Pacific Ocean so swiftly that the track followed the ship seemed to him like a swiftly moving stream. Question 6. What is the condition of the ship when it entered the Pacific Ocean? Answer. With the entrance of the ship into the Pacific Ocean, a new phase was begun. After the killing of the albatross, the ship of the ancient mariner was driven by the favorable south wind and entered the calm Pacific Ocean. It still sailed northward and reached the equator. The sun now stood directly overhead. It was intensely hot, and the sky assumed a copper color by the heat of the sun. But suddenly the wind stopped and the ship stood motionless. There was also no current in the seawater. This continued for some days. The ship then rested unmoving. It seemed like a picture, pictured on the ocean. A pictured ship remains all the time in the position in which it has been pictured by the painter. Likewise, the ship of the ancient mariner remained still in the same position for some days for want of wind and current. Question 7. When did the albatross come to the ship? Answer. Come to the ship, and how was it received? Answer. The ship of the ancient mariner entered the region of mist and snow. There was fearful sound and ice everywhere. There was no living things. Suddenly, a seabird called the albatross came to the ship through the snow fog. The albatross was received with joy and hospitality. It proved to be a bird of good omen and followed the ship as it returned northward through fog and floating ice. The albatross ate the strange food. It would hover around the ship. Favorable south wind began to blow at their back. Every day, the albatross responded to their call, either to take food from their hands or to play with them. It would come and sit on the mast or sails at the time of the evening prayer. This continued for 9 days. During this period, the moon shone deeply through the white smoke of the fog. Question 8. Why was the albatross killed? How did the other mariners react to the killing? Answer. The ancient mariner killed the albatross without any apparent reason. All the companions of the ancient mariner condemned his act of killing the albatross. They said that he had done a hellish thing and it would bring them misfortune. They said that he killed the bird of good omen, which has caused the favorable wind to blow. They declared the mariner of wretched being for having killed the albatross. But then the bright The sun rose, neither dim nor red, but luminous and glorious like the hallowed head of Jesus Christ. The sailors declared that the mariner had done the right thing by killing the albatross because it brought fog and mist. Thus, the mariners became accomplices in the crime committed by the ancient mariner. Question 9 described the suffering of the ancient mariner for killing the albatross. And so the ancient mariner killed the innocent bird albatross for which he along with his companions had to suffer a lot. After killing the bird, their ship entered the calm Pacific Ocean and it remained motionless for want of wind and current. The sun shone hotly overhead. Their throats were so dry for want of drinking water that they could not speak. They were unable to speak and are thus condemned to silence. Slimly, creatures of the sea crawl round the ship. Dead fires dance around. The water of the sea burns at night with various colors like witch's oil. In that very hellish condition, the sailors blamed the ancient mariner for their sufferings and cursed him. At last, they hung the dead albatross round his neck as a punishment. Suddenly, they see a ship coming from the horizon. Their joy turned to horror as they find that it was a specter ship moving steadily forward without any wind or tide. As it comes near, they are paralyzed with fear to find that the crew of the ship are dead and life in death. A woman, this terrible ship of death went away carrying the souls of the sailors except the ancient mariner. He was let alone in the wide sea. It was his highest punishment. Question 10. Is his punishment out of proportion to his crime? Answer. On a superficial view of the punishment of the ancient mariner, it seemed out of proportion to the crime. It seems that an unduly severe punishment has been given to the mariner for the mere killing of a bird. But we must remember the true significance of his crime. The ancient mariner shows no respect for the legendary sanctity of the bird of life. The bird is innocent, unsuspecting and loving. It comes at the call of the mariners and takes food from their hands or plays with them. To kill such a bird is needless act of cruelty and great violation of the law of love and hospitality. He shows hate for one of the creatures of God and thus has committed one of the blackest of sins. This is why suffering is so terrible. If he were given death, it would be an end of suffering. Hence, he is deprived of death and made to perform his penance in full. Thus, viewed, the punishment of ancient mariner does not seem to be out of the proportion to his crime. Thank you, friends, for watching my video.